What's going on YouTube? My name is Josh Nelson and today I'm back with another video. This week's lesson is on Black Betty by Ram Jam. Now unlike the last two lessons, we don't have to change the tuning at all for this song because it's just in standard tuning, which means that your strings are going to be E, A, D, G, B, E respectively. Alright, so without further ado, let's get started. So for the first riff, it's going to be the intro riff plus the solo that bleeds into the verse. And so what you have with that is you have power chords on the 5th and 7th fret with both roots on the E and A strings, which are shortly cut off. The rhythm player will keep playing it, but it's shortly cut off and we're going to be covering the leads into the lead solo part. And for that, you're going to be jumping all over the neck. And slowly, this first part sounds like this.
Thank you.
All right, now let's get into the verse. So the verse repeats itself three times in this song, and to start, you're going to be playing a chord, a minor 7 chord down here on the 7th fret, and then you're going to be playing another chord up at the 9th fret. So slowly, it sounds like this. All right, so coming out of that verse, you're just going to play that first riff that we looked at again before coming back into another verse. So the next part we're gonna go over, I'm gonna call the pre-solo riff, as it only happens right before a solo part comes into the song. So for the pre-solo, what you're gonna be doing is you're gonna be hitting power chords on the 5th and 7th fret, and then you're going to be playing one of three riffs right after that. They switch in what order they go in, but slowly, it sounds like this. So next we're going to cover the solo. So the solo I'm going to break into multiple parts, as it's just easier to look at it and practice it that way. So this first solo part is going to start down on the 7th fret, and you're going to be working your way up to the 15th fret, which is where the next part of the solo is going to start. So slowly, it sounds like this. So for the second part of the solo, we're going to go from the 15th fret starting point, where we left off from the last part, and we're going to be going all the way up until our first 17th fret bend, which is bending the B string on the 17th fret while holding your pinky on the 17th fret on the E string just above it, and you're going to be bending and then playing the other one. So you're bending into the note that you're going to be playing with your pinky, and slowly, that whole part sounds like this. Alright, so for this next part, there's going to be a lot of those bends that I was talking about, where you're bending up to the note and then hitting that same note with your pinky holding down the string above the string you're bending. And so that part's going to go up until we get to the 17th and 19th fret, where we have some faster picking going on. And you're going to be starting, of course, down by the 17th fret, and you're going to be doing the bends, and then there's going to be a riff. Some more bends that are slightly different than the first bends that we did, another riff, and then it's going to come into that last section. Slowly, it sounds like this. All right, now onto the third part of the solo. So for the third part of the solo, we're gonna be starting up at the 17th and 19th fret, playing this cool lick, doing a cool blues lick, and then once we finish off above the 12th fret in terms of the rest of this section, we're going to come back down to the 10th and the 7th fret, and we're going to do this descending thirds pentatonic lick, which is absolutely nuts. It's going to take a while to build up the chops to be able to play that, both in your left and your right hand. That's okay. It's normal. It's going to take a while to be able to get it down. And then right after that, there's this cool little chromatic riff that goes into the bopping section. So slowly, this third part of the solo sounds like this. Solo, we're going to go into the section that I call the bopping section, because it's just kind of shots of notes going through with the drums and the bass. And you're going to be starting down on the first fret, and there's going to be a small jump up to the fourth fret, but you're going to be sticking around the first fret, for the majority of this part, and slowly it sounds like this. So after this part, we go back into that pre-solo part where you're going to be up on the 5th and 7th frets, playing the power chords with the riffs in between. And then coming out of that, the intro to the solo, the main solo, gets played again, but the ending riff is different, and we're going to be coming up to the 11th fret and tapping rapidly with one of your fingers. I use my third, just because that's what I'm most comfortable with. But you're going to be coming up to the 11th fret, and then you're going to be tapping rapidly on 14 in triplets before sliding off and going back into the verse. So slowly, it sounds like this. Now that we're done with the third verse, we're going to go into the outro solo. So for the outro solo, you're going to be starting on your B string up at the 12th fret, and you're going to be going into a series of bends down the strings, followed by a cool little lick on the lowest E string before you walk up chromatically to end the song. So slowly, it sounds like this. That was Black Betty by Ram Jam. I hope you guys enjoyed learning it with me this week. If you liked the video, be sure to leave a like or a comment, and be sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell, as Beyond the Beat is uploading all the time, almost daily, and I'm here every week teaching a new lesson. If you want to keep up with all things me, whether it be stuff that's not this or getting live updates as to when these videos go up, be sure to follow my Instagram, which I will leave linked in the description. Until next week, peace.